Hey, Vinyl Community, it's VK here, Vance in the VK Lounge with part two of V's March Vinyl Madness. Going through a big haul I got earlier this week. I want to get through this and show you that. So we're going to just jump right into it. Again, man, I got these for 61 cents each. So you can do the math. We started off with Elton John's Greatest Hits, a later 80s pressing. It has the old Super Savers series on there, but we all know that one. Nice copy of Van Halen's 5150. ZZ Top's Eliminator. This one did get a little wear on the end, but still looked really nice and clean. Rolling Stones. Dirty Work. Didn't have the red cellophane on it, but nonetheless, I didn't have it. Did have the original inner sleeve on it, but it's nice to fill in the Stone section. Here's another little gem, bootleg for Jimi Hendrix. This one called Woke Up This Morning and Found Myself Dead with Jim Morrison and Johnny Winter and Buddy Miles. 61 cents. And it's on Stone Plain label. I'll show you that a little better. You seen that before? So I haven't had a chance to listen to this, but no scratches or anything on it, so I'm hoping it'll sound really good. Another classic album. I'm sure everybody has, but it's Frampton Comes Alive. Excuse me. And, there. So we all seen this. I'm sure everybody has that. Another classic, Led Zeppelin 4. In all nice shape. Didn't have anything by this guy, and I don't have a lot of his father, but this is Dweezil Zappa. Having a Bad Day. Remember when this came out? And this is on Barking Pumpkin Records, which I believe was Frank's album label. Little Dweezil there. Now, here's a nice little import, too, from my friend Robert Z. Michael Schenker Group. This is a Japanese import. It's a 12-inch for Cry for the Nations and Armed and Ready with the two live tracks on it. It didn't come with an OBI, but it had that on there. Michael Schenker 12-inch Japanese import. Now, it didn't come with an inner sleeve. This is on Chrysalis. But it did have the insert, the Japanese insert in Japanese with all the, song information on there. So that was definitely a plus, you know. I don't think it probably had a custom insert. Probably had something else. Just a plain white one, but I'll definitely fix that soon enough. But, I don't think I have any 12-inch Japanese. I think I have one or two Japanese imports, too, so that's cool. Never had this before, Eric Clapton's Rainbow Concert, featuring, Pete Townsend, Jim Capaldi, Ronnie Wood, a bunch of people. So that was definitely a plus. This is... I remember. I think it's an English import too. Double check here. Yeah. It's an English import on RSO. So always a bonus when you get that. You know, for us guys in the States, that's cool. I know a lot of the guys in Europe are like, "Ah, big deal. You guys want US pressing, so." But Eric Clapton's Rainbow Concert. Rat, Out of the Cellar. Didn't have this on vinyl. This is on Atlantic. Night Ranger, Seven Wishes. There's a band, a little underrated band. Everybody gets pigeonholed for the tune Sister Christian, but they had some good rocking tunes, Seven Wishes. George Harrison, Cloud Nine. Got the insert there with that as well, which is cool. Another Johnny Winter album, The Progressive Blues Experiment. It's on Liberty. So, you know, again, one of those guys, my wife, is not a big fan of the twins, Johnny and Edgar. They scare her. All right, I have an album by these guys, but it was cool to get this. This looks like an EP, I guess, The Alarm. Yeah, it's just an EP, or maybe even their debut from 1983 on IRS. It only features about 5 songs, so that's cool. Johnny Winter, Third Degree. It's on Alligator. I didn't know Johnny Winter was on Alligator, but now I do. Another Johnny Winter album called And. And this is on Columbia. Steve Miller Anthology. This is a heavy, nice, thick double album here. When you open it up, there's the booklet that comes in it. You know, put into the center of the page. Check that out. A lot of his earlier works before, the Joker and everything. So here's another little gem for 61 cents. A Chuck Berry picture sleeve back in the USA. And I think I only have like one Chuck Berry album, so this was a cool addition. I definitely, he didn't have the original sleeve that it came in, but I got this paper sleeve, but I'll see what I can find to put that in a little better so it doesn't get too beat up. But, you don't see too many Chuck Berry picture sleeves. I thought that was cool. Another album sleeve. My mistake. Chuck Berry. My producer over here giving me, correcting me. Because, this is one take. I'm not messing around with this, so. But here's another gem for 61 cents. A bootleg called File Under Scorpions. This is kind of odd. It's in an actual, manila folder file thing. I don't know if it's a little label or something was missing up here. But back in the day, this guy paid $11.99 from Looney Tunes for this. And on the back here has, a master sheet or something that was taped to it. These are live recordings. One side is from Japan in 1981, and the other side is from the US Festival in 83. So, a little smear or smudge on there, but I did get to listen to this. Doesn't skip, needs maybe a little surface cleaning, but sounded really good, and actually the audio quality is pretty good for a bootleg. So, File Under the Scorpions. Didn't have this in the David Bowie collection, don't have a lot. But this is David Bowie, Never Let Me Down. One of his 80s albums here. It's had the original inner sleeve with it as well. I filled some big holes with Sammy Hagar too. There's a bunch of Sammy Hagar in here. Here's another one, a classic, Standing Hampton. Yeah, one of my favorite songs on here, I'll Fall in Love Again. Probably the ultimate, screw you song, you broke up with me, I'll fall in love again. Another Sammy Hagar. What is this? Going around, I think. Oh, rematch, I'm sorry. Alright. Another gem for 61 cents. A live bootleg of Led Zeppelin, the Copenhagen warm-ups, the second night. So the one I showed you in the video before, the Melancholy Danish Playboys Get It On. That was the first night. This is the second. So I got both nights now. Very cool. And I had a copy of this before. But for 61 cents, I said, yeah, we'll include that with everything. I took the whole thing, too. Just made him a flat offer. And for all the stuff he had. So didn't leave nothing behind. But still, great. Can't find those in the thrift stores, that's for sure. Another Sammy Hagar Live, 1980. Yeah, a lot of people, I don't know, like Sammy or they don't, but I think he's a great performer, energetic, puts on a great show. Love Sammy. Led Zeppelin, another copy of the song remains the same. This one's a little worn up, you can tell. There's, I don't know, it's not ring wear, but something got wiped around that, but what are you going to do? It's funny, you know, you can tell the ones that look like got played a lot. Unless you got this somewhere else, I don't know. Pat Benatar, Crimes of Passion. You know, this first side of this album is pretty much a greatest hits. It's one of those great album sides with Treat Me Right, You Better Run, Never Want to Leave You, Hit Me with Your Best Shot, and Hell is for Children. I mean, right there, there's four hits on that one side alone. Bob Dylan's Knocked Out and Loaded. I'm not familiar with this album, but can definitely check it out. Got the inner sleeve there. That was nice. There's one I didn't have, and I don't know why I never picked this up, but I'm looking forward to hearing this. This is Willie and the Poor Boys. And this features Charlie Watts, Bill Wyman, Paul Rogers, Jimmy Page, Ray Cooper, and just a bunch of guys. Kenny Jones on here, too. Just a bunch of guys doing, you know, old tunes like Baby Please Don't Go and Slip and Slide In, some old blues stuff, you know, Let's Talk It Over. So looking forward to that. I didn't have the inner sleeve with it, but that's on Passport Records as well. And I believe, yeah, it's a Canadian pressing. Yeah, Canadian pressing on Passport. All right, next up, The Escape Club, Wild Wild West. UFO, No Place to Run. Can have this, I like to build up my UFO collection. Van Halen's OU812. Nice clean copy of that. Look at that, no ring wear on that. Has the embossed lettering on here. Albert Collins, Don't Lose Your Cool, another blues great, you know, on Alligator. Filling that blues section up with some Chicago blues, man. Albert Collins and the Icebreakers. All right, UFO Mechanics, another UFO one. They're on Chrysalis as well. Eddie Money's debut album. I don't think I have too much Eddie Money. He's all right, though. Another one, Playing for Keeps by Eddie Money. Another Sammy album, Three Lockbox. Taking that. Very cool. Led Zeppelin's In Through the Outdoor with the paper bag, and it's definitely intact. It's not ripped or anything, so I'm really pleased to get that. This is a later 80s pressing, though, as, you know, has the barcode on there, which is probably the first time I've seen that on this album. And the inner sleeves are as well. Looks like he didn't try to use the, you know, this is a watercolor inner sleeve, so you get a paintbrush with some water on it, and it'll change colors. He didn't attempt to do that, but really glad to see that the bag is intact. You definitely don't see that anymore. So, In Through the Outdoor. Next up, Tommy Shaw. What If? I don't have any solo Tommy Shaw. This is the first one I got. This is on A&M. Here's another gem, Judas Priest bootleg from the Summit in Houston called The Devil's Work. Two album set. Haven't had a chance to listen to this yet, but the two LP set right there. And, you know, back in the day, this was $15.99, 61 cents for Vans. Nice. This is, yeah, from the 83 tour around when Screaming for Vengeance came out. Nice little gem there. One of my favorite live albums, REO Speedwagon, You Get What You Play For. I don't care what anybody says. Take a listen to this, man. These guys, they rock out on this. This is just before the whole you can tune a piano era of the band came, you know, with the ballads and top 40 stuff. So they're still kind of a rocking, you know, Midwest band at this point. Jackson Browne, World in Motion. Didn't have this. Nice kind of, you know, glossy cover to it. Had the inner sleeve with that as well. That's always a nice thing. And it's on Elektra. All right, now here's a little odd gem that I got. Now this says it's from Procol Harum. It's Exotic Birds and Fruit, the album from 1974. This looks to be like at least what was written on here is an advanced copy, and there's something from the label on this here, some type of a paper, I don't know if you can catch that. But I don't know if it's a test pressing or what. I think it is actually now, if I remember when I looked at the label, and I'll pull that out for you. It's one of those cool ones I got. Yeah, it is considered a test pressing for Procol Harum. From Columbia. That's the side two there. Yeah, Exotic Birds and Fruits was the album from 1974. So this sheet of paper has the side, you know, the two side listings, and on the bottom there's a CC, you know, like when this letter was distributed as a memo or what have you, of who else should get a copy of this to check it out. So it's kind of an interesting thing. You must have bought this at the store for about $10, the Looney Tunes store, but it's pretty neat. Test pressing of Procol Harum, and I think I only have like a best of Procol Harum, so I'm going to check that out as well. But I thought that was a cool little gem in there. So, next up, Rod Stewart, Singing It at Broad. Now, I know this album came out with a more of a custom cut. This is an 80s pressing with the barcode on the back, but it was a die cut that came out more in the shape of a rock glass for, you know, and it would open up, I believe. I've seen that around, but kind of hard to find. It's on Mercury, later Mercury label. Let's see here. Starship, Knee Deep in the Hoopla. Yeah, at this point, Starship was kind of done in the 80s there. It's another Jefferson Starship, Nuclear Furniture. There's a nice another little gem for 61 cents. Jimi Hendrix Plays Monterey. So definitely looking forward to that on Reprise. Like I said, man, I don't have too much Hendrix, especially any live stuff, so nice to get that. Rod Stewart, Out of Order. Yeah, the 80s. This is when Rod was going big top 40 there. All right. Cheap Trick's Lap of Luxury. Another Johnny Winter anthology. And this is a CBS Special Products. I think it's an American pressing, though, but one of those budget albums at the time. On Backtrack Records. So definitely a lot of Johnny Winter stuff in here. You can tell his taste was pretty much rock and some blues in there. The Doors Classics. I don't know that, so that's cool. Stevie Nicks Belladonna. That. Now here's a German import for Deep Purple. This one's a little rough on here. Deep Purple, Greatest Purple. And on the top there, maybe my German friends will let me know what that reads. Maybe. This is a double album, a best of collection. All this is in German inside. It's on the EMI. But basically, you know, obviously greatest hits of their stuff. Show you the label on this. So, yeah, this needs a good cleaning. Got a little dust and air on there, but then you know the cover had some scuffs on the front here, but for a German import, and you know, it looks like a great collection just to pop on. You want some quick Deep Purple? Again, you know, 61 cents. Where are you gonna find that? White Lions, Pride. A lot of the 80 guys, I know you guys are, this is a hard record to find for a lot of the 80 metal fans, being it came out in the late 80s, 89, 90. Robert Plant's debut solo album, Pictures at 11. Yngwie Malmsteen, Trilogy. Nice clean copy of that. I did get the inner sleeve with that as well. AC/DC's Who Made Who. On Atlantic. Ace Frehley's Frehley's Comet. Another great one. Van Halen, Women Children First. This is a later 80s press too with the barcode. No poster, no inner sleeve. I do have this, but I still don't have a poster for it. I don't know how heck I didn't get one. I got it pretty much, you know, close to the release date, if not a year or two later. Here's a nice one too. I believe this was a UK import too. This is a Gary Moore Run for Cover, and is this hype sticker already on there? And the original inner sleeve, and this was on 10, I think the name of the label was. Yeah, it's just distributed by Virgin rather, but that's the label 10. I've never seen that label before. Didn't have any Gary Moore on vinyl, you know. Of course, we know Gary from the Thin Lizzy days. Big fan of Thin Lizzy as well, and then his solo blues stuff. So imagine that's kind of bluesy. Again, though, but you know, look at the condition of that. There's no ring wear. Corners are nice and sharp. Here's one that's hard to find, man. Rush, Hold Your Fire. Nice clean copy of that as well. I did get the inner sleeve with that. Was happy to see that in there. Hard album to find, being that this came out in the late 80s too, you know, when CDs started taking over. And here's another one of the gems in here for 61 cents, Rush Through Time. Collection of their songs. Take this one out because I know this is Mercury, and this is from Holland. So a Rush import from Holland. Not too shabby. Gotta like it. So it was one of those when I was flipping through. I was like, because I seen Jim Jamison show this. I think he, and that's how I even recognized the cover. I said, I seen that. So I think it was Jimmy that showed that. So it's like that VC vibes going around. Didn't have anything by Mark Bolan and T-Rex. This is the Slider. They have a little wear on this. But hopefully I didn't get a chance to play it or anything, but I'm looking forward to hearing some of that. This looks a little later. Let's see, it was distributed by IDS. Yeah, it came out in 72, and this looks like a reissue in 83, more of a collection. But a custom label here, I'll show you that. Kind of neat. Obviously this is after his death, so. Actually, the label is Mark on Wax. Mark on T-Rex. Humble Pie, the best. I don't have any Humble Pie. So check that out. You know, I don't know if this... this is when Peter Frampton was in the band, too. So another Johnny Winter. This is an And Live. Double live album. So definitely get some Johnny Winter going on here. Okay, another Gary Moore import. And this is from England, and this is White Knuckles. Another little gem in here. I'll show you that on Raw Power record label. Yeah, you know, you can definitely tell those English imports. They have those flimsy album jackets. I don't know why they did that, but just, you know, and use that big cardstock that we'd use in the. Here in the States, and I know a lot of the English guys love to get records like that because they're like nice and heavy. Sammy Hagar, 9 on a scale of 10. This is a reissue of his album. Probably Capitol started reissuing these once he started, you know, having some hits and brought off his earlier catalog. This is on the Green Capital label. Never seen this, so definitely a new listen for me. I was around when this came out, and Boston finally released their third album after almost 10 years. It's just Third Stage. Had a chance to see them in concert on this tour with Brad Delp. It was definitely worth the wait, I thought. I went up to Alpine Valley up in Wisconsin to see them. So that was one of my top shows, too. Jimi Hendrix, Smash Hits. This is on Reprise as the original inner sleeve to that. So that's cool. Iron Maiden's Power Slave for 61 cents, Iron Maiden. That says the textured cover, the inner sleeve. Vinyl's nice and clean on that as well. All the vinyl on these are pretty good. Another Maiden, Number of the Beast, 61 cents. Eric Clapton's Behind the Sun. Gatefold copy, great, real good album. It's featuring Phil Collins on drums on this. There's another Clapton one, but let's throw in Jeff Beck and Jimmy Page. White Boy Blues, classic guitars of Clapton, Beck, and Page. So cool to get this. I don't have any like compilations like this. I imagine probably featuring some of the Yardbirds work in here and stuff. Look, John Mayhall's on here as well. So definitely cool. Yes, 90125. Sound, you know, was probably one of the big comeback albums, arguably. For a band. This was huge when he came out. Jeff Beck Flash. Gonna have this. Joe Walsh. But seriously, folks. Nice. I think this has Life's Been Good on there. Great tunes. Here's another gem. I don't have anything surprisingly and embarrassing Lee by this guy. I know a lot of you do. A lot of you are big fans, but finally got at least one. It's not as one of his, you know, most popular, best, or what have you, but still, it's a start. Frank Zappa meets the Mothers of Prevention. I don't have any Zappa. I have one Mothers album, but I don't have any of his stuff. My buddy Jason's a big Zappa guy. He's had the original inner sleeve with the insert too, so I was happy to see that. It's just kind of hard to find out there, obviously in good condition at decent prices. And this is on the Barking Pumpkin Records. So looking forward to that. And I had the little order form there as well. This opens up. So. And I think this came out around the time when those the congressman wives formed the PRC. So he kind of threw this back with a warning sticker about, you know, kind of mocking the whole thing and called it Meets the Mothers of Prevention. You know, Frank Zappa kind of put them in their place, though. They didn't expect that from Frank. Scorpion's Blackout on Mercury. Earlier pressing on that. Didn't have this album either. Savoy Brown. Looking In. Actually, going back to my buddy Jason, he has this, says it's really good. So I'm looking forward to that. Parrot Records on the label there. Montrose's second album. Paper Money. Very cool. Another Jeff Beck album, Truth. Like, as you noticed, really stocking up on the Beck. 38 Special. Tour de Force. And I'll finish this segment off with Michael Schenker Group, Built to Destroy. Alright, and that's on Chrysalis. All right, so that's part two. I guess I'm going to have to do a part three, but that's part two of V's March Vinyl Madness. Thanks for stopping by, guys. I hope everybody's well, and stick around. I'll show you what this last section is here, and I'm going to top it off with something pretty cool, too, for 61 cents. All right, guys, everybody take care.